Hi, and welcome to my guide of the quest Garden of Tranquility. The quest requirement is Creature of Fenkenstrain, and the only stat requirement is 25 farming. Items needed is a Ring of Charos. If you've lost it, you need to pickpocket Dr. Fenkenstrain in his tower of his castle. Then you'll also need a rake, a seed dibber, spade, a filled watering can, secateurs, a gardening trowel, two plant cures, and a filled plant pot. These 9 items can be easily bought at any farm shop near any herb patch, except for muscle harmless. Then you will also need 3 cabbage seeds, 3 onion, and 1 marigold seed. You can buy these from the Grand Exchange, pickpocket from a master farmer, or you can simply buy them from the seed seller in the Draynor market. Then you will also need a fly or a regular fishing rod, a hammer, a pestle and mortar, and a rune or pure essence. Now it is also recommended to have 5 super composts, because these will give your farm patches 2 extra lives. You could use regular compost, which you can easily buy from any farm shop, just like the other items, but that will only give your herb patches 1 extra life. Now you'll also need a game necklace of at least 2 charges, at least 2 teleportation methods to Port Phasmatys, either via an ectophial or via the charter boats, but that will cost you approximately 1,600 GP per trip. Then you'll also need like 2 teleports to the Ardy farming patch, 1 teleportation method to Edgeville, 1 to Draynor. I will be using 1 glory charge for each. Also a teleportation method to Catherby, 4 to Falador, and then 1 to Lumbridge. And then lastly, 1 teleport to Varrock. You might also need a couple of coins if your patches will become diseased, so you can go to the nearby farming shop to buy an extra plant cure. Where to start this quest is in the garden of the Varrock Palace. Talk to Elamaria. Just skip through the dialogue by pressing the spacebar. And then just select the first option, I would be happy to help. Just keep pressing the spacebar once again. And now we will need to go to the wise old man in Draynor village. But first we will need to be able to pick up this list. Because you will need 1 empty inventory space, so you will need to drop a certain item, pick up the list, read it, and now you will need to go to Draynor. So teleport yourself to Draynor village and head to the wise old man. When you're there, talk to him. Select the first option about Queen Elamaria. Keep pressing the spacebar and he should ask you 7 questions. When we answer all these 7 questions correctly, he will enchant our Ring of Charos. For the first question, you can't really use your numbers on your keyboard, so you will have to use your mouse and select option B, show them a range of colors. Question 2 about the drunken dwarf, select option C, take his generous gift. Question 3, select C again, definitely. For question 4, select option A, put on the silly helmet. For question 5, select option C once again, of course, BK Master. For question 6, option C once again, I will do whatever you ask. And then for the final question, select option C once again. If I do, I will let you know. And then you'll see that your Ring of Charos has now an A next to it. Just like the first option, thanks. Once your Ring of Charos is enchanted, let's go northwest and go to Eslan at the Falador farming patch. So just keep going northwest, enter the cabbage field. Keep going north until you see the tool leprechaun. Exchange it and store your super compost. And then talk to Eslan, pretty much near the tool leprechaun. Then select the first option. Do you have any Delphium seeds to spare? And now we just need to keep using the charm option. So select the second option, then the third option. Now you just need to keep using the charm option until he will trade the seeds for marigold. Then select that first option, I will grow you some marigolds. Next, rake the flower patch. Then exchange the tool leprechaun, grab a super compost, use it on the flower patch, and then use your marigold seed on the flower patch. And now you just need to wait for it to be fully grown. Now let's hope it doesn't die, and let's get the other seeds. So I'm going to exchange the tool leprechaun, deposit the bucket, get an extra super compost, and let's now go to Port Phasmatys. If you have not completed the quest Goes Ahoy yet, you will need to go to the bank and be sure to get 1,600 GP. Go to the most southern dock of Port Phasmatys, pretty much next to the boat to go to Zaya. There is a trader crew member. Trade him 1,600 GP and he will take you to Port Phasmatys. If you have completed that quest, just use the ectophial and you're arrived. Next, go west and go to the Port Phasmatys farm. Once we have arrived, we will need to talk to the gardener of Port Phasmatys, which is called Lyra. And once again, we will need to ask for the orchid seeds this time. But then we will just need to keep using the charm option. Keep using the charm option until she will trade it for some onions. Alright, finally, when you have three options that you can choose, choose the first one. I will grow you some onions. Then, once again, rake one of the two allotments. Select your super compost while you're raking and use it and hover it above the allotment. Wait until the allotment is cleared. Use it on the patch, then use three onion seeds on it. Drop your weeds. And now let's go to Ardoin. So teleport yourself to the Ardoin farm patch, either via the cloak, either via the medium diary completed cloak or via a regular Ardoin teleport, and head yourself to the farm patch. We need to do the exact same thing with Kragan, the farmer at the Ardoin patch, asking for some seeds and keep using the charm option. Before I'm going to do that, I'm going to exchange the tool leprechaun. Drop the bucket, grab a super compost, and talk to Kragan. You have some snowdrop seeds, and now just keep using the charm option until you need to grow him some cabbages. And it's a deal. Rake one of the two allotments. Select your super compost and hover it above the allotment, and now just wait until your character has done raking it. Use it on the allotment. dip the seeds in the patch, drop your weeds, exchange it to a leprechaun, drop the bucket, and let's now go to Berthope. So wrap your game necklace and select the first option. Next, go south southeast and go to the inn. Enter it via the northern door. Then go southeast inside of the building, and there you should see a door going outside. If you go outside via the east southeastern door, you should find Bernold. Talk to him. Keep pressing the spacebar. Then select the second option, the charm option. And then select the first option, accept the deal. And now use your plant cure on the diseased vine grapes, just south of the wall. Then talk to Bernold again. And he will mention a druid. So now we will need to go to Taverly. Click south on your minimap and wait for your character to run to that location. You may drop your vial, you don't need it anymore. Now just keep going south until you reach Taverly. Let's go east because we will need to go to Alain, the guy that protects your regular tree patch on the eastern side of Taverly. So let's pass the druidic circle east of the witch's house building, and then just south of that quest start, you're already at the tree patch. Talk to Alain and select the first option. I need to ask you about strong plant cures. Then do not select the charm option, just select the first option. Is there anything you can suggest? Next, use your hammer on your rune or pure essence to smash it into shards. Then grind those shards with your pestle and mortar and use that dust into the plant cure. Next, use your game necklace and get back to Berthope. Or you can simply run back if you don't want to use a game necklace charge. Just get back to the garden, going through the inn, and use this darker green plant cure on the diseased vine grapes. And they will be cured. Talk to Bernold, and he will give you fine seeds. Next, we will need to go to Edgeville. Actually, we will need to go to the monastery just west of Edgeville. So first I'm going to the bank and grab a stamina potion. And now let's go west and go to the monastery just west of Edgeville. North of the monastery, south of the sheep, you will find a small cabbage field and three different kinds of roses. Next, near the roses, you should find Brother Athelic. Talk to him. Then select the second option, the charm option. And he will ask you to dump the ring inside of the Edgeville well. Let's do that, so let's go back east and head back to Edgeville. What you also could do is destroy your Ring of Charos, but then you will need to go back all the way to Dr. Fenkenstrain's castle. You could, if you are on a necromancy spellbook, that could be a little bit faster, but since most of us are not using necromancy spellbook, just go back to Edgeville, right click and use your Ring of Charos on the well, just northwest of the bank. And now let's go back to the brother next to the roses. Because we have dropped ring inside of the well, he will agree to give us some seeds. So let's talk to him. Try to take a seed from a rose. Alright, after talking to him, try to take a seat again, and he will allow you to take some seeds. Take seeds from every single kind, the red, the pink, and the white rose seeds. Once you have these three seeds, let's go back to Edgeville. Now it's time to fish the ring out again. So let's go back to Edgeville and use your fishing rod or your fly fishing rod on the well. And now you just need to wait until your character has fished your ring out. This could take a couple of tries, so if you fail, just use your rod on the well again. Just keep reading what is happening in your chat box, and you will see that you have retrieved the ring or not. Alright, when you finally got the ring back, equip it, and now we will need to go to Catherby. Teleport to Camelot or get yourself to Catherby. Now I just need to talk to that Dantaria woman and select the first option, how could I grow a white tree? And now just keep selecting the charm option once again. And now she will say that the last white tree is located on Ice Mountain. So teleport to Falador, go north, and let's go to White Mountain. The white tree is next to the Oracle from the Dragon Slayer quest. So let's go back northeast, following the brown path. And let's go back to Ice Mountain. Alright, west of the monastery, let's go west and climbing up the ice mountain. When you see the ice fiend, just go north until you see the Oracle of the Dragon Slayer quest. You'll also see a little dead bush sign on your minimap. Near the Oracle you will find a white tree, use your secateurs on the white tree to take a sapling. Once you have this, use it on the filled plant pot and you will get a white tree shoot. Now let's go back to Falador and check up on our marigolds. If you have a watering can in your inventory, use it on the shoot to water it. If you don't water it, it will not turn into a sapling. So I'm now going to Falador, check up on my marigolds, and also grab a watering can from the tool leprechaun. Hopefully the marigolds has not died, else I will need to go back to Draynor and buy some more seeds. First I'm going to exchange the tool leprechaun, grab my red ring can and use it on the tree shoot. Be sure that you water your tree shoot. You can deposit your watering can once again. Now my marigolds have not finished growing yet, so I'm going to check up on my other patches. So I'm going to use my ectophial and I'm going to check up on my onions. The onions are not diseased, else I would have gone to the Port Phasmatys bank, grab some coins, and then I will have to buy a plant cure from the farm. Okay, now I'm going to check up on my cabbages. First, I'm going to grab some cash. So if my cabbages would be diseased, I will be able to buy some plant cures. Also a second stamina potion, coins for the plant cures, one extra Ardoin teleport, one extra Falador teleport, and that's it. Let's go to the cabbages. And let's see, the cabbages are not diseased. Since all three of my patches are not diseased, I'm simply going back to Falador. And now I'm just going to wait near my marigolds and wait until they are fully grown. You don't really need to run this part. You don't really have to hurry to get your marigolds. Even if they are fully grown, you still need to wait on your cabbages and on your onions. Alright, when your marigolds are fully grown, pick them, then talk to Eslan, select the first option that you have some marigolds for him, and he will trade them for Delphium seeds. Now let's go to, let's say, Port Phasmatys, and now we will need to wait for our onions to be fully grown. Now, what I actually didn't really notice until maybe a couple of years ago, that there's always a farm shop near a herb patch. So for example, here in Port Phasmatys, the farm shop near this herb patch is just like, it's just a shop inside of that farm. I think the woman's name is Alice from Animal Magnetism quest. For the farm shop near the herb patch of Falador, it is just inside of that building south of the cow field. Just north of the loom, there you'll find also a woman that will sell you farm stuff. For the one in Catherby is pretty obvious, it is just directly next to the farm patch. For Ardoin, it is a little bit further away, but there's also a farm patch. And then lastly, for the herb patch on the Troll Stronghold in Trollheim, there's also a farm shop, but that is actually the Tool Leprechaun He will also sell you plant cures and other farm stuff. Now, because of the rewards of the diaries, we have a 6th herb patch now in Muscle Harmless, but there isn't a farm shop just yet. Alright, let's now just keep waiting for these onions and cabbages to be fully grown. I'm bored waiting. I'm going to try to plant them already in the garden of the queen. So teleport to Varrock and let's go back to the queen. Hopefully we can plant these already. If not, it's just an extra time waste. Then it's just extra time for our onions and cabbages to grow. I will need to grab a second Varrock teleport from the bank. Hopefully I will not forget it. When you're back here in the garden, rake the vine patch on the western wall. Use your vine seed and hover it over the vine patch. Just wait until your character has done raking. Use it on the vine patch. Next, let's go a little bit south. Rake the Delphium seed just on the southern wall once again. And hover your Delphium seeds above that patch. Plant them, rake the white tree patch just next to it, hover your sapling above it. You don't need to water or use compost on any of these patches, they will grow automatically, full health. I think the queen will do that, probably her servants. Alright, plant the sapling, rake the three bushes and then just use the corresponding seeds to the patch. The western one is pink. Alright. Rake the red one. Plant the red one. And then lastly the white one. Plant the last seed, and now let's go to the bank and grab that extra Varrock teleport. You may drop your seeds in your empty plant pots. Let's go to the bank, grab a Varrock teleport, and then we're going to head back to Port Phasmatys to check up on our onions. One Varrock teleport and let's go back to Port Phasmatys. And the onions are still not done. Great! Have fun waiting, I guess. Oh, first let's go to the tool leprechaun, because we will need to use our two last super composts. I'll be sure to not get attacked by the random vampire, so let's stay north of this allotment. And now we just need to wait for these onions to be done. Have fun waiting, I'm going to do something in the meantime.
Thank you.
Alright, when you get a message in your chat box that you should check on the cabbages and onions that you've planted, talk to Lyra. Select the first option that you've made the onions and she will give you 2 seeds. Let's now go to Ardoin and let's stack up on our cabbages. Now, if you did not get the message about the cabbages, that means that your cabbages has been diseased. So buy a plant cure and get back to the cabbages immediately. And use a plant cure on your diseased cabbages. And then you just need to wait for an extra cycle, maybe even 2. And wait for your cabbages to be fully grown. But since I have used a super compost and they got 2 extra lives. Just say to Kragen that you've planted his cabbages and now you'll get your snowdrop seeds. Once you have these, let's teleport back to Varrock. If you haven't already, go to the tool leprechaun near the tree patch of Varrock, grab your 2 regulars or super composts. And let's go back inside of the garden. Open the kitchen door, exit. Now when you enter the garden, you will see 2 plant pots. Use a regular or super compost of both of the plant pots. Then use the yellow orchid on the eastern plant pot. And then use the pink one on the western one. Then rake the snowdrop patch on the eastern wall. Wait for your character to be done. Hover your snowdrop seeds above the patch already. Alright, drop your weeds, drop your buckets maybe, for some less weight. And now when we are done with these, talk to Elemeria. Select the first option, what am I supposed to do with the statues. And she will give you a trolley. Let's first go to Falador. So teleport yourself to Falador. And in the center of the city, you'll find the statue of Ceridomin. Use your trolley on the statue of Ceridomin to trigger a cutscene. After this cutscene is over, we will have the statue on our trolley. Alrighty, when the cutscene is over and there is a porty marker above your trolley, let's right click and push it once, then go stand south of the trolley, right click and big push, and let's push it north, follow it north, right click, big push once again. You should need to do this approximately like 3 or 4 times, and then you should be teleported back to Varrock. When you're in Varrock, use a big push once again, follow it, a second big push, now it shouldn't, follow it once again, maybe do a small push, then maybe 2 regular pushes east, then stand north of it, 1 push to the south, then 2 pushes to the east once again, so you're still able to stand north of it, and then just do a big push south, maybe twice, until it reaches the wall, go stand east of it, do another big push. It's 1 square too far away, so let's stand east of it, push it singly, fucking hell, push it 1 square west, so it is in the doorway, big push south. Alright, push the trolley in between the 2 orchids, between the 2 plant pots, do another big push. Then push it next to the table and do a big push so the statue goes south. Then do a little small push so it is next to the statue plinth. Maybe let's push it next to it. Once it's next to the plinth, right click the 4th option, place. And you'll take the trolley once again in your inventory. Now that the statue has been placed, let's go to Lumbridge and let's get the 2nd statue. After this statue is placed, you just need to wait for the snowdrop seeds to be fully grown, and then we have completed our quest. So here in Lumbridge, let's go a little bit east. And near the entrance, you will find 2 statues. Use your trolley on the southern statue. This is the one of a king. This will not trigger a cutscene. Let's stand west of it. Do 2 small pushes to the east. Stand south of it, a big push north. Then let's do another 2 pushes north, or maybe even 3. Stand west of it, big push and go across the bridge. And once the statue is on the bridge, this should trigger yourself teleporting to Varrock. Alright, when it does it, once again, do 2 big pushes. Stand north of the statue, do a small push south, and then just do another 2 big pushes east. Pull the trolley, go stand north of it, big push, let's push it to the wall or the fence. Stand east of it, another big push. Should maybe be 1 square too far, so let's pull it. Then do a big push south. Then do a big push to the eastern wall. Once it's next to the plinth, place the trolley or place a statue. Now we need to talk to Elemeria. And now, once again, we will need to do a little bit more of the waiting game for our two orchids and for the snowdrops to be fully grown. After you think these are fully grown, let's talk to Elemeria. And if they are fully grown, she will say that you will need to get her husband, the king. And if not, you will still need to wait for these flowers to be fully grown. So have fun waiting once again. Alright, when you think your snowdrops and your orchids are done, let's ask for Elemeria for the confirmation. When she says to get her husband, let's go back inside of the castle. Via the kitchen, via the back door, then open the door just south of the kitchen door. Just go south, enter the smaller room south, and inside of that room or near that room, you should find King Rold. Talk to him. Select the first option, ask him to follow you. then select the second option, the charm option, once again. And after he follows you, the quest should be completed. Alright, after the cutscene is over, skip through the conversation a little bit, and congratulations, you have completed the Garden of Tranquility. You are awarded with 2 quest points, 5000 farming experience, an apple tree seed, an acorn, and 5 guam seeds, and also a compost potion 4. This compost potion can be used on any compost bin filled with regular rotten contents, which will make the regular compost change into super compost. So for example, if you put 15 cabbages in a compost bin, then use this compost potion on that bin, it will transform into super compost after those 90 minutes, except for regular compost. Also, let's pick a fruit from the white tree patch. You're only able to do this once and you'll get a white tree fruit. This is just like a strange fruit and this will give you some run energy. This was my guide how to complete the Garden of Tranquility quest. Hopefully it helped a little bit. Subscribe, rate and comment. Okay, thanks, bye!